The Sydney harbour has become cleaner. More and more wildlife has found it a nice place to live. And for whales, seals and dolphins, a lovely place to visit. But one endangered species still needs a helping hand.
They sit in the soft push of bayside current. What look like milk crates or gas main guards are in fact luxurious waterfront accommodations for one of the harbour's struggling tenants, the Sydney or White's seahorse.
White seahorse is one of only two endangered seahorse species of 50 or so on Earth.
With their population dwindling, the Sydney Institute of Marine Science embarked on beefing up their number by beefing up the seahorses themselves.
So we can, for instance, go and collect the food, the little shrimps that they need to eat right from the harbour, fresh that day for them.
And then there was finding them a place to live, a difficult thing in Sydney, hence the seahorse hotels.
The tail of a seahorse is essential. It's the slowest moving fish in the ocean, so they need that tail to hold on to something, otherwise they get swept away in the big swells and strong currents.
It's a busy business, seahorse breeding. For Dad.
So in the animal world, the seahorse is the only animal where the male gives birth. 100 to 150 babies at a time, and once he gives birth, the female will then go and impregnate him again. So she might reproduce with him four or five times over a breeding season.
Gee, she's keen. The dads and the kids taking to the shark nets of Chowder Bay on their release today.
Six pregnant dads came from right here, so the good news is they're getting their kids back, but more than they probably would have got if they'd popped them out in the wild.
This is the biggest, most powerful, strong seahorses we've ever released. They're super seahorses.
In Mossman, Mike Dalton, Nine News.